Najee Harris not the only rookie who is ready to, quote, run with it.
I need him so dead.
McGillicuddy in action.
Well, the current Intercontinental Champion, Kofi Kingston, teams with his rookie, Michael McGillicuddy. It's tag team action in our main event next.
We are back on NXT. There you see Mark Henry and his rookie, Lucky Cannon, set for tag team action against Intercontinental Champion Kofi Kingston there on your right and Michael McGillicuddy.
Michael McGillicuddy in the teal tights as the pros watching on here, getting ready for this main event tag team matchup.
So after this matchup, all eight rookies will have participated in action here in the first 2 weeks on NXT, and it's going to be interesting to see where the pros think they stand. First pros poll in 2 weeks' time.
I like the fact that the pros for both teams starting out in this tag team matchup, trying to set the tone, set the pace early. Get one up for their rookies to come in and make an impact.
And what a better way to evaluate your rookie, Josh, being in the ring with him.
Wait, so what's going on here now? Forget everything I just said, because it appears that Michael McGillicuddy wants to start the match. McGillicuddy, son of former Intercontinental Champion Mr. Perfect, the grandson of Larry the Axe Henning. But McGillicuddy feels that his opportunity is now. Feels he has a ruthless style, very aggressive inside the ring, and he's going to need all of it and some against Mark Henry.
The world's strongest man, Mark Henry, 416 pounds. We have heard a lot, Josh, about Michael McGillicuddy.
Colson, since there's no one else for me to ask out here, do you think it was smart that McGillicuddy wanted to tag himself in and start this match?
I think it shows a lot of gumption from the youngster. I think what a great way to...
Appears to me, though, that Mark Henry called McGillicuddy into the ring to start the matchup.
And look at the world's strongest man. Oh! And McGillicuddy, welcome to the WWE. And now Mark Henry going to drag McGillicuddy to the corner, and in off the tag comes Lucky Cannon. 6'5", 238 pounds.
Why is he lucky?
Quickly into the cover, hook of the leg, and a kick out. I'll tell you why he's lucky. At 21 years old, he helped a buddy of his who was in trouble. He was being attacked, and Lucky Cannon got hit in the head with a steel bar. He was in a coma for a number of weeks, lost 45 pounds. And look what he's doing today. Indeed, lucky. And McGillicuddy taking Lucky Cannon to school early on. Nice arm drag takedowns by McGillicuddy. Lucky Cannon telling me earlier that he actually holds the world record in shoelace tying.
What?
He demonstrated it earlier.
Look at this nonsense.
He does it less than a second.
How does that benefit anyone?
He thought it was impressive. And Kofi Kingston,
right there,
the Intercontinental Champion, into the ring. And Kofi Kingston with a big night Sunday night, defending the Intercontinental title against Drew McIntyre.
Well, the first ever fatal four-way event taking place this Sunday from Long Island.
Kofi Kingston, nice take down of Cannon, big splash, hook for the leg, and Cannon kicks out at one. And tag made yet again to Michael McGillicuddy. Says he likes to be very aggressive in the ring. Finds himself being very confident.
McGillicuddy got his in-ring name from his mother's maiden name.
Here's the cover yet again, and a kick out.
Paying homage to all sides of his family is Michael McGillicuddy. Come on now.
Told me earlier today that he wants to make a huge impact, and that was a quote. He says that is all that matters here in the first week of NXT. Well, first week for McGillicuddy, that is. Oh, nice standing drop kick to the jaw. And Cannon rolls out of harm's way. Uh-oh, there goes Mark Henry. And Kofi and McGillicuddy looking good. Can they keep it up when we return to NXT? We're back on NXT. It is a tag team matchup. There is a Michael McGillicuddy versus Lucky Cannon. Cannon, the rookie of Mark Henry. McGillicuddy, the rookie of Kofi Kingston.
The first match for both of these rookies here on NXT Season 2. So important is the first match. Get out of the gate early. Get that first victory. Get the monkey off your back. And then you can move on from there and just capitalize and build and build and build and try to impress the WWE pros as well as the WWE Universe.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we began NXT tonight with the rookies and the pros in the ring talking about the confrontation from last week where the WWE pros initiated the rookies. MVP basically offered an olive branch and said, let bygones be bygones here tonight. We're going to do it the right way. This class, Season 2 of NXT, is going to be better than the first time around.
They even saw it.
And look at Lucky Cannon into the cover, hook of the leg, and a kick out.
So Zack Ryder talking to his rookie.
Another cover by Cannon, kick out again.
Titus O'Neil just trying to get on the same page, trying to make sure that everything flows so we can have a great competition here on NXT Season 2.
Yeah, that's one of the things about the rookies and the pros' relationships. I mean, they've only been together for 2 weeks now. Really learning about each other's personalities, learning what each other can do in and out of the ring. Lucky Cannon telling me it's been a great 2 weeks so far with his pro, Mark Henry. As Mark Henry comes in off the tag.
Mark Henry is a veteran of the WWE. There's so much that Lucky Cannon can learn from the world's strongest man, Mark Henry. Not about just what happens inside the ring, but almost just as important as what happens in the WWE locker room as the pros. You can see them watching on, evaluating this main event tag team match.
McGillicuddy sidesteps Mark Henry. It's interesting you said that, Josh, because Lucky Cannon said one of the things he is learning from Mark Henry is not only how to act in the ring, but how to act in the locker room, how to act out on the road. Really learning the ropes to become a superstar here in WWE.
The WWE locker room can be a very scary and intimidating place.
Said he learned about being intimidated as the youngest of five brothers in his family. Everything was a competition growing up. And look at this. Cannon very competitive in this matchup with McGillicuddy. Mark Henry coaching from the apron. Kofi doing the same thing as well. McGillicuddy, Josh, telling me earlier today that he believes the most important thing for him is the fact that he believes in himself, that he believes he can win this competition.
It's one thing to believe in yourself the way that McGillicuddy
Cannon
does.
Quickly into the cover.
It's another thing to not give your opponent the credit that he deserves.
Another shoulder knockdown. I like how Cannon quickly goes for covers here, trying to put McGillicuddy away.
Don't get in a rush, but take your time.
Another shoulder knockdown, another hook of the leg, and McGillicuddy again kicks out. Almost a smile creeping across the face of Lucky Cannon as he realizes he has McGillicuddy on the run.
Keep fighting, man. You cannot quit. Come on, Mike. Let's go.
And remember, it all goes back to the beginning of this matchup.
Come on, Mike.
The rookie McGillicuddy started for his team. Mark Henry started for his. And you can see that Lucky Cannon and Mark Henry have the upper hand right now.
Mark Henry was goading McGillicuddy into this matchup to start things off. I mean, in retrospect, was it wise for McGillicuddy to get in the ring there?
No, as you can see the way things are breaking down right now.
Cannon went for the crossbody, and McGillicuddy sensed it, ducked out of the way.
Wasn't so lucky there.
Oh, nice spinning.